I welcome you to Rim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through business studies form 2. Lesson number 23, the topic it is government and business. Welcome. Let's look at the lesson objectives. We are going to discuss ways in which government is involved in the business activity. We start by looking at the methods of government involvement in business activities. In our previous lesson, we managed to look at the ways in which government gets involved in business. We also discussed about the reasons why it should get involved into the business activities. And today we want to look at those methods that government gets involved into business activities. One of the ways, it is by use of regulation. Now, when we are talking about regulation, the government may regulate business activities in various ways. They include through the licensing. A business cannot operate before it is allowed by the government to do so. So do you look at the forms of business that we discussed in Form 2, you are going to, in the first topic, you are going to get that all business organizations starting with a sole proprietorship should have the license in order for it to start. This is done through the issuance of a license. Now, let's look at the reasons for licensing. One, regulating the number of business in any given time. You regulate the number of business that are operating in any given time of that certain way. Number two, controlling the type of goods entering and leaving the country. So you're able to control those goods that are coming in and those that are going out. Number three, to raise revenue for the government. That is also another one. You are able to raise revenue, or the government is able to get the revenue through the licensing. Then ensure only legal activities are carried out. You can be able to see legal license, meaning that that one has been allowed to be carried out in that country. Number five, to ensure that there are no illegal businesses carried out in the area. Then, to ensure that those who engage in professional activities meet the requirement. So those who are involved in the business activities, they meet the what? The requirement. Number two, it is ensuring standards. Remember, in my previous lesson, when we were looking at the different ways in which the government get involved into the, or the reasons as why the government should get involved, we mentioned that to protect the consumers. This is how the consumers are protected by the government, by ensuring standards. The government regulates business activities by setting standards that businesses should meet and ensuring that the standards are adhered to. So you set the standards and ensure that those standards are adhered to. This is done by the KEBS, that is the Kenya Bureau of Standards. Whose main responsibility is set to standardize all the goods and services that are offered. You can be able to see their offices, and also you can see their motto, which is Standards for Quality Life. Number three, it is registration. The government may come up with rules and regulations that regulate business activities. For example, you can be able to see during this period of corona, we have the sanitizing of hands by the transport sector, transportation sector. You can see And these are the rules that are set by the government. Businesses are expected to strictly adhere to the set rules and regulations. So the Matatu sector is supposed to meet and adhere to those set rules of the Ministry of Health through the government. Then we have the next one, it is training. The government regulates, takes keen interest in training people. Many are done at Kenya Business Training Institute. So you can get that people are being trained. For example, you have the Madira Technical and Vocation College that offers the training to people, how they expect how businesses are supposed to be carried out. Reasons for training: it exposes them to modern development in management. There is one. Educate them on efficient methods of operating business. Number three, it exposes business people to problem facing them and their possible solutions. They're marking the end of a lesson. This is the activity. Explain four methods of government involvement in business activities. If at all you want to get the reference or referring, you can refer KRB 2011 Innovator Secondary Business Student Book 2, that edition. If at all you want to contact us, you can get us through the SMS. You can also get us from the YouTube. You can also get us from the Facebook, and you can Twitter us. Stay tuned to EdimTV. Thank you.